Hey guys, it's your girl Melanie, and I'm back with a reaction. This is a different reaction because I'm going to be reacting to Kevin Samuels in Future's music video. As you guys may know, he was there a couple days ago on location in LA, and now it looks like we have a little preview or a little snippet of the music video that's going to come out. It's not the whole thing. This is probably going to get copyrighted. I don't care, but I thought it was interesting because your godfather's making money moves, baby. When they say there's a ceiling, no, we breaking it. All right, so let's see what's going on over here.
So Future, I want to commend you on your bravery.
Thank you.
I mean, admitting you have an addiction is never easy, especially when you do it publicly. So Chanel, Birkin, Dior, APs, five-star hotels, vacations. And last year, how much did you say you spent on women?
Probably around $2,000-$3,000.
It's not so bad.
$3 million.
Million?
Yeah, every time I see a beautiful woman, I have to splurge, I have to spoil them. I'm realizing that I have this problem right now. I need help.
When was the last time you went on one of these sprees?
Let me think.
All right, guys, when I first saw this on Kevin's Instagram, if you don't follow him on Instagram, make sure you follow him. At first, when it said Dr. Kevin Samuels, I was like, oh my gosh, congrats, Kevin, you got your doctorate. I'm so dumb. I literally was not getting that this was I thought he was doing an interview with him. That's how slow I am. But this looks good. I'm excited about this. Oh, wait, I didn't fix my screen, y'all. There we go. I'm so excited about it. But yeah, so kind of like a lot of guys see Future as kind of like that, Future, he kind of came up with the phrase, she belonged to the streets. So a lot of men like to use that. But what I wanted to highlight in this is that a lot of people have tried to say Kevin was going to fall off. He's going to, he's hit his ceiling. He's going to get canceled. All these different things, right? But as you can see, the Godfather is thriving. And this is the thing everybody needs to understand. Just because other people doubt you, just because they can't see it, just because it looks like it's going down, it doesn't mean that it is. Kevin didn't talk about this. He didn't promote it. He didn't do anything until you start seeing him going to LA. I know O'Shea talked about this the other day as well. But this is what I find interesting. You know what? People are always going to talk about you. People are always not going to like what you're doing. People are always, this is what O'Shea had to tell me, because I was feeling discouraged doing what I'm doing, because I get attacked by like hurt hoes, not women, but men who are, very hurt that I happen to look halfway attractive and I have the nerve to come on YouTube and talk about stuff. So, and I was kind of feeling low about things, but he told me to keep going. And this is the message, I think, for a lot of us. It don't matter what people have to say. It doesn't matter if you're a contrarian voice. If you, like, you have something to say, say it. And you just put in the work and you grind. And I remember O'Shea even shared in his video that 5 years ago, Kevin were doing a live together, and Kevin was talking, it was excited because he had gotten 500 subscribers. So that just shows you, if you put your head down, do the work. I don't care where you are today. I don't care what people have to say about you. Sit down and do the work. And I'm talking to myself right now. I need to sit down and do the work. But your boy's making money moves. So, I don't care what you think about Kevin. I don't care what you think about Future. Clearly, this is a power move. And, haters gonna just need to sit down and drink that hater rage. Shout it. Okay, I'm doing too much. Bye, guys.